Good morning and good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the DEXA presentation in sport medicine. My name is Arnaud Lenisch. I'm the Europe Product Marketing Leader, and I will present you in the next slides how DEXA could be useful in sport medicine. So just to start with this funny picture, and just to remind you that I will focus my presentation on body composition, but you have to keep in mind that what is also important to follow to the athletes is their bone mineral density also, very linked to body composition and muscle. So just to start, I would like just to remind you what does DEXA measure. DEXA means dual X-ray absorptiometry and is the gold standard, of course, to measure bone mineral density and to measure fat mass and lean mass. Fat mass is adiposity in the body, and lean mass is including organs, muscle, and liquids in the body. And you can have also an extrapolate the percent fat and the percent lean in the full body. But as you can see on the right, we deliver also in the reports and in the software, the total body image that you can see there. But also you can work in the different region of interest of the full body. I mean the arms, the legs, the trunk. And you can also have a color coding mapping showing the level of adiposity of fat, for example, in yellow, and the level of lean mass in red in this example. Just to give you also a reference in terms of values, you have below the table, that is the American Council reference on exercise, where you can see that standard patient, I would say, should be for a woman between 25 to 31% of fat mass, and for a man between 18 to 25%. But as you can see, the athletes need to have between 14 to 20% for women and between 6 to 13% for men. So that's why DEXA is very important, as you will have in detail what your body has in terms of percent fat and also in terms of lean mass. So why DEXA is so useful in sports? I would say that during the life of a sport athletes, there are three pillars. The first one is to achieve the peak performance, to be at the top condition during the season. So to achieve a peak performance, we need to define a pre-season baseline, as you will see in the next slide. And it will be very important also to follow, to monitor the training on the nutrition program effects and to see the impact on the body composition of the athletes. Another application is to check the balance between the right side and the left side of the body. And also, like I shared to the first funny picture, what is important also is to check the bone density for many athletes, like the non-weight bearing sports, like swimmers and cyclists. The second level of application of DEXA for sport athletes, that is also very important when we know that many athletes are part of the Olympic centers, Champions League soccer teams, is to maintain the top condition of the athletes and to check it. In order, firstly, to anticipate the fatigue factors, but also to monitor during the season the body composition of the athletes to be sure they are at the top of condition. And for that, we need a good reference database, and we need to compare an athlete with reference database very linked to the sport concerned by the athletes. And last but not least, There is an application for the young women, the young athletes, the female triad disease that can be diagnosed and monitored by DEXA. And the third application of DEXA is the follow-up of the rehabilitation after an injury. We know that the body composition is very impacted by the injury, and we need to have a pre and post-injury monitoring to help the athletes to come back to the competition. And also to help them and to build and monitor a relevant rehabilitation program and diet program to be at the top condition after an injury. And I will finish to explain you how also DEXA can be used to monitor the athletes after their retirement. And it will be a great tool. Excuse me, could you put in mute, please? Thank you. Thank you. So that are the three pillars of the presentation. Thank you. So firstly, to achieve a peak performance, the first information, like you can see, for example, for this athlete, we see that this athlete during a period that should be maybe a vacation period, a break period, or maybe an injury, can have a high level of fat mass. Fat mass is black in this graph, and a low level of lean mass, that is muscle. So it will help to start with the baseline and to monitor these athletes after a program to come back at a good level of lean mass. For example, like this is the case there, we can see that these athletes in few weeks come back at a high level of lean mass, and we know that lean mass is mainly muscle for the athletes, and after to follow the athletes during the season and to be at the top condition. So we can see that DEXA allows to establish the pre-baseline at the beginning of the scans period, and to follow during the period and to check if the diet and the training plans are working or not. And also, for example, if the athletes stop, for example, in this case, the diet programs during a break period, as it was the case there, as he has a high level of fat mass. So you can see there that we see very in detail the follow-up, the monitoring during the seasons of an athlete. It's also very useful to monitor the training program on nutrition programs, like you can see, for example, in this case. It's helping to identify some athletes losing lean mass or fat mass when others cannot lose. Also to check if the nutrition program has the desired effect to the athlete's morphology. And you can see, for example, in this case, this athlete did a high protein and low fat diet on a muscle strengthening program and won on his weight increased by 96 to 97 kilograms. But with the DEXA, we can see what happened in his body in detail. We can see, for example, that his program worked very well, as this athlete won 3 kilograms of lean mass, so of muscle, and lost 2 kilograms of fat mass. So that is a great example there, showing really in detail what the athletes won and lost. Unlike the nutritionist Richard Allison, who is the former head of nutrition of Arsenal soccer team, is explaining that DEXA machine is quite often used as a marker of success, and it's a very good way to influence and motivate the players. Another application of DEXA for the peak performance pillar is the possibility to differentiate and to analyze the symmetry or asymmetry of the athletes. As we know that many sports need a good balance, like soccer, jump long, athletes, swimmers, runners. And you can see, for example, that many times a good symmetry is very important for the performance in many sports, like Australian kickers. And many times we can see that non-symmetry can impact the level of performance of these athletes. And in this case, for example, we can see between the right and left side that the left side has 49 kilograms of tissue compared to 46 kilograms on the right side of the same athlete. But if we look more in detail, we can see that it's more the lean mass and the muscle that is impacting this asymmetry of the athlete. So you see there that DEXA is very useful to analyze in detail the different region of interest and eventually the non-symmetry of the body to correct it with a dedicated program. And last but not least, for the peak performance pillar, we have to be careful also for many sports like the non-weight bearing sports, like cyclists, swimmers, sports having no impact on the floor and impacting directly the bone of the athletes. That's why it's very useful, like you can see this study on the right, that BMD screening and monitoring may be really recommended in elite cyclists, as we know that elite cyclists have a much, much lower BMD than reference population due to the fact they are doing a sport without impact on the floor. So having said that, you are probably wondering the delay between each scan that should be that is advised to do. And just to reassure you, even if DEXA is an X-ray system, the dose is very low. As you can see on the right in the table, the DEXA total body scans are very low in terms of dose compared to other X-ray systems. But just to give you funny comparisons, to make a total body scan, one total body scan could be the equivalent of eating 10 bananas on IDEXA or 5 bananas on Prodigy, knowing that in bananas we have potassium 40, and or the equivalent to smoke one cigarette due to the polonium in the cigarette. So it's really to show you that the dose is very low. And in general, our customers using DEXA for sports athletes or for body composition in general are scanning people every 3 months in average, just to give you an idea. So when your athletes achieve the peak performance, we need also to be sure that he will keep this high level of performance, high level of fat mass and lean mass, in order not to have risk to be injured during the season. So that's why you can see that we have very detailed reports where you have the lean mass with that is mainly the muscle and the percent fat also that could be compared to a reference population. I will show you later that you can also customize your reference population. But when you follow an athlete or a patient, what is also very important to have in mind is that the precision of the system is the best indicator, and it's the lower the precision is, the best it is for the follow-up of an athlete. Why? Because the precision is called the coefficient of variation, and it will impact what we call the least significant change with this formula. And the least significant change is the minimum of change you can monitor or detect between two exams with a significant variation. We are sure that the patient is losing or winning fat mass, lean mass, and this is not the error of the precision of the system. So that is very important to have this information in mind. And if you are interested by that, you can consult and read the publication of Dr. Karen Hind that is a part of ICD. We did a very great study on the best practice of DEXA in sport, and we analyze all the publication of the 37 past years of all the studies done by all manufacturers about precision in sport medicine. And as you can see, Lunarai DEXA is really, in terms of precision, the gold standard, the best system on the market to monitor body composition with the best precision. You can see that, for example, if we take the blue study, we have 30 females and 30 males were scanned two times of different sports, and the level of the precision is 0.3% for lean mass, and between 0.6 and 1.5% for the fat mass. And it's really below the maximum limit requested by ICD. So just keep in mind that when you work on body composition with a DEXA system, the precision is very important to take in consideration. You can also, with the Anchor software, also you can compare your athletes or your patients to reference population, and you have the possibility with Anchor 18 version to customize a reference population. I mean to create, if you want, like you can see there, custom male reference population, create your own reference population of athletes. For example, if you have soccer teams, it's better to compare a soccer player to a reference population of soccer player and not a standard reference population. And it's possible in the software, integrated in the Anchor, and to have the results in Z-score or in centiles. So you have the possibilities to have that. And just to give you many references that you can find in the literature, for example, for National Football League players, the subcutaneous adipose tissue is around 12% of body fat, and the visceral adipose tissue is around 20% of body fat. Just to give you many ideas, but you can create your own reference population with a high level of athletes and a high number of athletes to create such population reference. Last but not least, for this top condition pillar, is the triad disease that many high-level athletes, young athletes, female athletes can have. And it's a mix of disorder eating habits, menstrual dysfunction, and osteoporosis. And with DEXA, you have a way to evaluate in one exam, scanning spine and femur for osteoporosis to detect if there is a problem of osteoporosis, and with a total body scan to have a body composition exams and information to check the problem of disordered nutrition. So in terms of application, we have many centers like Olympic centers following the young athletes just to check they don't have such triad disease. That is a problem that we can see in the young professional athletes. And what is important also to take in consideration is that these amenorrhea athletes have between 2 to 4-fold increased risk of stress fracture compared to amenorrheic athletes. So it's very important to take in consideration and to follow by their teams, by gynecologists in the medical centers, these athletes. So in terms of the last possibility of DEXA system, that is one of the more important what I would say also, is the possibility to follow the rehabilitation of the athletes after an injury. We know that an injury can cause regional atrophy due to lack of exercise, less mobility. And the goal of rehabilitation could be to achieve the same body composition than before to be injured, or to compare the injured side versus the non-injured side, like you will see in the next slide. So for example, if we take this athlete, as you can see, has a high level of lean mass. So the lean mass is a pink color, and the black one is the fat mass. So we can consider that during the season, he was as the top condition there, and he was injured, and we can see that he lost a lot of lean mass on one fat mass. In this case, he won 3 kilograms of fat mass and lost 1 kilogram of lean mass. And if we want to go more in detail, it's clearly possible. Like you can see in this example, it's another athlete who was injured on the left leg. And we can see there, he was injured at this date. And he lost a lot of lean mass before restarting rehabilitation to come back at the level of his top condition of his left leg during a rehabilitation program. So it can help you to go more in detail, and like you can see in the tables provided by the DEXA system. At the first scan, the athlete was very high in terms of lean mass in the left leg, 13.4 kilograms of lean mass. At this date, he was injured. So he stopped exercise. So he didn't have lost yet a lot of lean mass. But during 3 months, he lost approximately 900 grams of lean mass of muscle because he stopped definitively exercise. He restarted exercise at this date for rehabilitation. And we can see that he's back at a level of 13.2 kilograms of lean mass. That is very close to the level of lean mass before being injured. So you can see there that DEXA is a very great tool to see in detail and to monitor also the different regions of interest. And it can be very useful for to monitor the legs or the arms of the athletes when they are injured, and to check if the rehabilitation program is working and helping the athlete to come back as his top condition lean mass. And just to end the follow-up rehabilitation program, I would say that also many private centers can help after the end of the career of all professional athletes, can help them to continue having a great level of body composition in their body, because when they many professional athletes stop their activity definitively, going to retirement, many are winning a lot of weight and fat mass because they are not following their diet program. And many doctors with DEXA help them to continue having a great, I would say, the health profile during the rest of their life. And it's also one of another application of DEXA. So as a summary, I would say that DEXA is super helpful in terms of achieving a peak performance, maintaining top condition, and following rehabilitation. And for that, as I explained you, precision and accuracy are key. And that is the case of the iDEXA, for example, that is used in the main Olympic imaging centers and main Champions League soccer teams in Europe. So that's why DEXA is very useful. And I would like just to share you that to help our customer to work in sport medicine, we have developed the sport athletic package with two possibilities. The first one is the possibility to scan the full body for adults without head. And the second possibility is to segment the arms and legs region of interest with sub-regions. the upper arms and the lower arms, upper arms to be close to the biceps, lower arms to be close to the forearm, and the same for the legs, with the upper leg area to be close to the quadriceps, for example, and the lower part of the leg to be close to the calf. And I would like just to switch to the Anchor software to show you an example how it can be used at the end. For example, if I take this athlete, we can see that at this date, he was injured to the left leg. So if I select left leg in the software, we can see that he lost approximately 900 grams of lean mass of muscle. But if I want to go more in detail, I can check if it's more in the upper or lower region of the leg, going in the software in the left leg upper or lower. If I go in the lower part of the leg, we can see that he lost lean mass but before to be injured, but it was stable after the injury. So finally, if we go in detail, we can see that he lost principally in the upper leg, so in this quadriceps area, we'll say, the lean mass, so we can be more accurate following the lean mass on the muscle in this upper leg area, region of interest. And we have also, on top of the Sport Athletic package, a tool called Analytics that can help to put in place many threshold values. And for example, I did a table like this one, a graph like this one, where you have in green, I segmented the lean mass of the left leg with different level of lean mass. So in green, it's above 30.2 kilograms of lean mass. In yellow, it's between 12.8 to 13.2. And below 12.8 kilograms, it's red. And it's a way, it could be a way to motivate the athletes. For example, we know that it was in his left leg. He was in the green area there at the top performance. He was injured at this date. And he lost a lot of lean mass to in a red area I have defined. It's really a graph I have customized, and each customer can customize like he would like. And the target during the rehabilitation program is to come back in the green area, to come back at the same level than before the injury, like you can see there. And I can do the same for the upper region of interest of the leg. I can be again more precise to be in this region of interest. With the analytics tool, I can say to the athletes, you were there before to be injured. You lost a lot of lean mass. So you were there during the period you did no exercise, and you have to do exercise now to come back at the same level of lean mass than before to be injured. So it could be a target, and visually it's very motivating for the patient to have such graph that you can define. I define it with the level of lean mass that this athlete has in his legs, and you can do it like you want, and it's a great tool to motivate the athletes. So that is how it could be useful with the Sport Athletic package and with the analytics tool. And I would like just to end the presentation to share to you also that all our customers can also join our G-Cares platform. We have a G-Cares platform that is a clinical platform, 100% clinical, where we have a lot of content posted by customers, publications, studies, best practices, like Dr. Karen in the study I shared to you just before. We have more than 700 members actually sharing. You can like, you can follow all the articles, you can post also. But you can also be part of a forum called Dexan Sport, where we have more than 100 members, where the customers can post their experience, their best practice, and everything linked to Sport and Dexan. So that's why I wanted to share to you during these 30 minutes.